in what will come as the most damning revelation that directly questions the integrity of the office of the Prime Minister and the Prime Minister himself, the Managing Director of the Kenya Bureau of Standards, Dr. Kioko Mangeli, and his Chief Manager, Testing Services, John Njoroge Gikubu, have sworn two separate affidavits detailing how the Prime Minister has allegedly been pressurizing them to release the maize said to be contaminated. In the affidavit sworn before Commission of Oaths Joshua Chalo and dated May 12, 2009, Dr. Mangeli says KEBS conducted tests on its said maize and the results released on 1st of December indicated that the maize was contaminated. He further claims that at the request of KEBS, the government chemist conducted another test which similarly found the maize to be contaminated. Dr. Mangeli swears that despite the tests, an administrative officer in the office of the Prime Minister, a Mr. Karoli Omondi, called him severally, ordering him to clear the maize. Mangeli says at one point, Omondi called him on phone telling him to either behave or he would deal with him. At the end of January this year, Mangeli claims a person from Cereals Board and another one only identified as Mr. Koshik from a company called Euroworld visited him, during which they urged him to authorize the release of the maize. Mangeli swears that after he refused to budge, the said Mr. Koshik called someone on his phone, during which he allegedly uttered the following words, and I quote, "The dog is not behaving," end of quote. Father Mangeli claims that on February 26th, he attended a meeting convened by the Prime Minister in his office, during which the Prime Minister allegedly rubbished the results of KEBS and those of the government chemist. In his affidavit, the Chief Testing Manager corroborates the above claims and adds that during the February 26th meeting, the Prime Minister uttered the following words, and I quote, "KEBS' involvement in import inspection is not within its mandate and there is nothing wrong in importing substandard and counterfeit products as long as there are willing buyers," end of quote. Dr. Mangeli claims that after the meeting, the Prime Minister's office instructed a private firm, Intertech International, to conduct private tests on the maize. The firm found the maize fit for consumption. And in a different letter addressed to the head of civil service, Ambassador Francis Mudhaura, the PS in the Ministry of Industrialization, Professor John Lonyangapuo, also seems to accuse the Prime Minister of a sinister motive, questioning why the PM's office instructed Intertech to conduct tests on the maize without consulting the other government agencies involved. Lonyangapuo claims when the cabinet subcommittee visited Mombasa to inspect the maize on March 2nd, the maize is shown appeared different in color from the yellow maize that they had earlier seen. The PS also questions why the maize whose quality was in doubt was offloaded from the ship into a silo in the absence of any relevant government officials to ascertain the maize had actually been taken to the silo without being diverted into the market. Overall, all the documents seem to suggest that nobody can really tell whether the maize has been diverted to the market and is already in circulation or whether indeed it is the one in the silos in Mombasa. Olivia Ketch, Citizen TV.